welcome to Women Now. It's been a while and I'm glad you're back again talking about money, money, money.
Yes, thanks for having me. It has been a while.
Yes.
And we're going to start a three-part series. Actually, I'm very excited about that. This is going to be ideas for a better retirement for women.
Women.
Yes.
Particularly women.
Absolutely.
Okay. We need to know all about it. Why don't we go straight into it?
Done. Let's get into it.
Mm-hmm.
So women have made impressive gains in the workplace and are emerging as leaders in a growing number of professional fields.
Mm-hmm.
However, these gains mask a much gloomier economic portrait for many older female employees. And the story is particularly dire for retired women struggling to avoid poverty as they age.
Now, is it different? Is there any difference between men and women when it comes to retirement planning?
Yes, there is a huge difference between the two. And women continue to have lower earnings than men. They are thus less able to make sufficient retirement plan contributions.
Okay.
They take time away from their careers to have families. This reduces their income, thus driving down the size of their retirement nest eggs.
Mm-hmm.
It also reduces their lifetime earnings and ultimate Social Security benefits.
Okay.
Time off from work is also likely to delay and impede salary increases and affect career trajectories.
What about nursing care and help at home?
Yeah, see, the nation's primary caregivers provide hundreds of billions of dollars in unpaid care each year. These earnings, of course, have no beneficial impact on retirement incomes.
Okay.
Women outlive men on average by several years. This forces them to spread a smaller amount of assets over a longer number of retirement years.
Okay.
As a result, the poverty rate among people age 65 and older is nearly twice as high for women as for men, 9% versus 5%.
Wow.
And the Government Accountability Office, the GAO, interviewed retirement experts and assembled a list of suggestions in Social Security,
mm-hmm.
401k, and other plans, private pension plans, to help improve the economic future for older women, Inna.
All right, okay. So that seems like, you know, you need to share some findings.
Absolutely. These are very, very important findings. So the first one being automatic individual retirement account. So employers who do not sponsor a pension plan would be required to automatically enroll employees in an IRA unless the employee opted out.
Okay.
The caregiver contributions to IRAs, that's the second one, allow all caregivers to contribute to the IRAs up to the qualified contribution limit, which would be based on the individual's adjusted gross income in the year prior to becoming a qualified caregiver. Then third would be create Social Security earnings credits for unpaid caregiving. Workers who take time out of the workforce to provide care, a group dominated by women, could have their Social Security benefits increased. So the next one, Anna, is the ease employer retirement plan eligibility.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, employees are generally eligible for 401k plans once they have at least 1,000 hours of service during a 12-month period. Reducing this requirement would accelerate retirement contributions.
Okay.
It would particularly help part-time and short-term employees, a group which is obviously dominated by a lot of women.
Okay.
So provide public education on the impact of delaying Social Security benefits. That's the next option.
All right.
Many people elect to begin Social Security benefits as soon as they turn 62. Which is the earliest age for claiming the same?
Getting there.
Right. Okay. Okay. Security benefits will increase by about 8% a year from age 62 to 70.
Okay.
Then they're talking about raising the retirement ages. By raising the ages for early retirement, now 62, and full retirement, now 65, employer may choose to work longer, resulting in additional payroll tax revenue and raising retirement incomes.
we need to stop here today and wait for the next series, the next part of the planning.
Yes, this
we'll
is
bring you back pretty soon again. I hope we learned something today. I'm going to remember only a few things here. One is that for men and women, it's different when it comes to retirement planning,
right?
Because women lose a lot of time and years of earning, so their
right.
earning is in general less. And also that increasing the retirement age from 62 to 66
right.
results in some benefit.
You got it.
All
you
right.
picked up very
See,
well.
See, I'm
Ina.
Learning well.
And hopefully the viewers are picking up the same yeah. way as Ina has picked up.
Sure, so, and don't forget to tune in next month when you're going to come back with the part two.
Part two, and that will be very informative again. This is a complex topic, and
yeah.
we'll go gradually.
But we need to know, we're all getting there. Come on,
I
60
know.
Is not that
I
far
know.
Anyway.
That's right.
Now, also, from money to fashion, let's take you to the Bindas Girls.
All right.
Hello there, Bindas Divas. Hope you all are doing fabulous. And here we are again, another week, another trend. Today we're going to talk about the trend of color blocking. We've been seeing this trend all over the runways in Hollywood and Bollywood. What's color blocking? Color blocking is combining several solid colors to create one complementary outfit. The key in color blocking is to make sure the colors are complementary. Do you want to try this trend? Try it with saris. A lot of saris these days have the color blocking aspect to them, with several solid complementary colors. You'll be sure to pull off this trend without a hitch with the sari. So, here's your tip of the week, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you in 2 weeks.